Hey man, welcome to the broadcast of the Theo Bond Show, man. If y'all's ready to get your coffee at the finest grounds, man, grounds, coffee grounds. Hey, Theo, let's be honest with our audience. What you talking about, man? Ladies and gentlemen, this is not the actual Theo Bond Donald Trump interview. This is but a parody. For those of you who thought this was the actual interview, well, it kind of is, but not really. No, this is just a parody. Thank you. Hi, y'all. So, this is Theo Vaughn, and so I have Donald Trump on the broadcast. It's a very special broadcast, so just sit back, relax, man, 'cause we're gonna talk about some bullshit. Know what I'm saying? I have no idea what I'm talking about. Ladies and gentlemen, here's former President of the United States, Donald Trump. Donald, welcome to the Theo Von Show, brother. All right, how you doing, brother?
Well, Mr. Theo, it's good to be here. Let me tell you, first of all, I really enjoyed being on your show 2 weeks ago, I think it was. And I'd like to thank the American public for supporting me as much as they have, especially after I got shot. There was lots of congratulations for living, Mr. Trump, lots of that.
Well, let me just for real, dog. I mean, you are an American badass. You know what I mean, dude? Like, my God, you get shot, and then, okay, bud, like, you get up, you tell the Secret Service. Wait. I was laughing my head off, dude. I couldn't believe it. You got up and went, fight, 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 fight. Dude, do you realize how boss you looked up there? Man, that is crazy. Straight up crazy. I mean, you were reminding me of my coke days, man, when I just used to snort the coke off of strippers' titties, and I'd get up there, I would do the same thing. I'd pump my fist, but instead of fight, 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 I think I was saying something else that started with an F word. Know what I mean?
Well, Theo, let me tell you, most of that was adrenaline. I mean, goddamn fucking eBay. I mean, I am a badass, but most of that was adrenaline. I got up. I thought I gotta say something. I just got shot. So I was like, fight, 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 you know? That's. Anyway, the rest is history.
Yeah, but it was still pretty badass, man. You know, you got to admit that was pretty wild, dude. Yeah, I hate that eBay train whistle they got going on right now. Know what I mean? Like, it used to be subtle, right? Like, it was just a ding dong, and now it's a dang-um old train whistle, man. How crazy is that? Jeez. So, you got a few nicknames you like to be called, Mr. President, like the Trumpster or Trump Hogan or, you know, anything like that?
Yeah, I don't know why they installed the train whistle. Theo, let me ask you a question, man. You ever have your balls itching so bad that you're just right in the middle of a really good scratch, like you're just digging in there so good? And then, like, your wife comes in the room, she catches you, or like you have company over and they catch you. Then you have to go to the bathroom just to scratch your balls. You ever do that?
That's a real wild, like, off the topic thing for a president, a former president of the United States to be saying, but I know what you mean, dude. Like, you really, like, you might be standing out in the middle of public, and it's kind of like the nose picking deal. You know what I mean? Like, you be sitting there at a red light, right? And you get your finger right up in there, and someone pulls up next to you, and it could be somebody you know, and then you have to explain yourself the next day. It's kind of, see, there's that gosh damn train whistle again, man. I'm telling you, get you every time. But you gotta come up with a really good story. Like, you can't just sit there and say, I'm scratching my balls. Nah, hell nah. You gotta say something like, oh, I was just adjusting myself. But it's like, I don't even care anymore. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you got an itch, you gotta scratch. You know what I'm saying?
Well, you can always do the one thing like I like to do, as you take your hand, just stick it deep in your pocket, and then you just scratch away. You just really dig in there, get underneath, in between, and oh man, there's no better relief than scratching your balls, man. But anyway, enough talking about that. We'll get talking about more important things here. You ever reach into your freezer and pull out up a fudgesicle, and you want to eat that fudgesicle just right there and then? You rip off the wrapper, and you really try not to eat it really fast so you don't get the ice cream headache, But you just can't help it. You want that fudgesicle so bad. Like you're trying your best just to get out to that fudgesicle, man. Slay. I gotta have that fudgesicle. I can't help it. I gotta have it. And you chomp down on it. And then you properly choke because they give you your fudgesicle on a, those sticks that the doctor sticks in your mouth. It presses down, your tongue goes, all right, say, and you're trying to say, oh, you go, oh. You hit hell crazy. And then you can taste the wood.
Oh yeah, bruh. Yeah, I do the fudgesicles. Hey, do you remember? Wow, man. I said remember weird, dude. Like, I don't know. I said funny, but do you remember the pudding pops? Oh my God, dude. I would strangle. Like, well, I really wouldn't commit violence on a person. Can't say that on YouTube, brother. But I would commit violence on a person just to get a hands on one of them there, pudding pops, brother. Heck yeah. Oh, hell yeah. It's the way you say it, Mr. President. You gotta do it with a little bit of twang in your voice too, and go, hell yeah. You know what I'm saying?
All right, let's see if I get this right. Oh, hell yeah. Is that any good? But yeah, I remember pudding pops too, man. I did not like vanilla. I hated vanilla. I love chocolate, though. You got any chocolate, pudding pops? I know they've been discontinued, but you never know.
Wow, That's like wild, man. But you know, who is it? Randy? No, not Randy. Dennis Quaid is playing Ronald Reagan in a movie, man. Yeah, like about his life and stuff. Like, who would you choose to play the part in your life, man?
Oh, that's easy, Alec Baldwin.
Alec Baldwin? Wow. Yeah, I can. Man. Haha. Yeah, I can kind of see that, but honestly, I think he would just more or less make fun of you or do like the SNL skit type of thing. I don't think it would. He would really, truly represent you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know. I know. Just hear me out here, okay? Just Alec Baldwin. I know he does a hey look. He does a great impression of me on Saturday Night Live. Okay, I know he's probably doing it to make fun of me, and I'm pretty sure I've heard him say bad things about me in the past. But that's kind of the reason why I'd want him to do it, want them to do it. You see, because that way. He would have to learn more about me. He would have to learn the truth. I think it would really open his eyes. I think that he would see if, that is, if he was given all the proper information and decided to go with it. You know what I'm saying? Like, if they then decide where we're going to go with the script, the way that the fake news, the fake news deals with Donald Trump. When I could go with the truth, which is what everyone else sees about Donald Trump, you know what I'm saying? Like, it would really have to be done right. And I think that it would open his eyes and a lot of other people's eyes. Much like Dennis Quaid, as you mentioned, his eyes have been opened. I think he sees the real truth.
Wow, dude. Oh, wow. You went really deep with that one, man. I wasn't even expecting that. Like, you just, bruh, you totally, man, whew, you hit me upside the head with that. But I think at this point it wouldn't matter, though, because, like, he killed that chick, you know what I'm saying? With the pew pew. And, his name's kind of drug through the mud, kind of like Bill Cosby, you know? So I don't, even if he opened his eyes and spoke out in your name, I don't think necessarily you'd want that to happen, because then now you've got a guy who, you got a murderer. You got a convicted murderer, you know? Even though it was claimed to be an accident. But yeah, you know what I mean?
Yeah, but Theo, Alec chipped a nail. You two go understand. He was never actually convicted, by the way, I don't think, but I think they dropped all the charges. Is that right? They dropped all the charges. And they dropped all the charges. But anyway, I mean, you do what make a good point. Now, Bill Cosby, I wouldn't want him really speaking for me, you know. That would be terrible. That would be terrible. But, and he got off. He got off because of a technicality. Now, when I become president, I mean, you've already seen what Kamala did. She locked away all those innocent people, no, behind bars that were wrongly convicted. And she let all the really dangerous criminals onto the street to cause chaos and destruction. And when the peaceful protesting went on and on, I did the bunny ears on a Vegas seminar. Well, when that went on and they were destroying buildings and cars and really, actually, the whole city was getting destroyed on that one. But yet, Sleepy Joe and her did nothing to stop it.
Yeah, that's pretty wild, man. Hey, no way, bruh. Ha ha. Look who we have coming on the show right here. Look at this. Bro, buddy, pow. Kapow. Ha ha. What are you doing here, man?
Hey, I just wanted to see how you guys were doing. You're kind of boring everyone to death, man. And, you know, you have no real entrance, so... I don't know. Anyway, I just want... You guys are actually funny, especially you, Donald. Hey, man, I'm sorry I haven't had you on in my shows, you know what I mean? I think you're gonna end up hurting my career.
Joe, you big stinking animal, get off of my interview. You're here on my interview with the hack's the matter with you. You know, you're like a rock, a poison playing a rock, pretending to be a rock, and then all of a sudden, what is he? Is a human being out on now? Anyway. You're on my interview. Get the hell off of my interview. What's the matter with you? Oh, wait. Had they already established that? You don't see me stepping on your interviews, do you? Oh, wait. No, I actually do. But never mind that. You lost ever my interview. You son of a muggy biscuit-eating, frozen, let it snow. Double dribble playing asshole.
Hey, eat my shorts, asshole. I can do whatever I want. I can do whatever I want. You come out here and tell me what to do. I'm a guest on my friend's show, Dio Bond Show. You know what I'm saying? Right. Why not? I do what I want out here. That was just one example. You don't tell me what to do, motherfucker. I'll curve stop your ass.
Hey, whoa, dude. Like, okay, man. I totally get it. Like, I know why you guys are fighting and shit. But this is supposed to be a chill show. You know what I'm saying? And in a way, he is kind of right, Joe, know what I mean? Because, like, you're coming in on his interview, dude. You know what I mean? Like, check it out. That would be like if he came in on Bernie Sanders' interview, okay? Oh, wow. That would cause all kinds of chaos and havoc and... It would be Donald Trump's Secret Service guys versus Bernie Sanders' Secret Service guys. And wow. You talk about a brawl to settle it all, bro. You know what I'm saying, man?
Allow him to talk smack like that to me. In the middle of my interview, that's it. I'm done. Interview's over. Goodbye, man. Those in.
Go ahead and leave, you dweeb. Nobody has you to be in here anyway. Oh, wait. No. Theo did, didn't he?
Oh, you guys, come on now, man. I mean, this is all supposed to be peace and harmony. But hey, it's about time to start wrapping things up anyway, y'all. And I appreciate my very special guest, President Donald J. Trump. We hope to see you on the program again sometime. And also, I will give you, sir, the honor of closing out tonight's show. How'd that be?
Well, you're lucky I stuck around. But honestly, It's been a pleasure and my honor to do the show, and I hope to do it again sometime, of course. And as always, please like the video and subscribe to the Hebrew AI voice parody channel. And this is President Donald J. Trump. Hopefully I'll be your president again, saying God bless America and good night, everyone. Oh, and one more thing. Do, 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 do. But I can't wait to be on the Joe Rogan show for real, y'all.
Boy, that was a horrible, horrible video, wasn't it? Even Mr. Donald Trump himself at the very end there didn't get to go do, 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 do properly. But I tell you what's not proper is when my brother orders from Grubhub. You should be ordered from DoorDash, brother. I tell you, it's a crazy, crazy world we live in.
Yes, you're right, Adam. They should be ordering from DoorDash. DoorDash is quick, inexpensive, and, well, convenient. I mean, let's face it, there's a certain amount of convenience there that most people don't get. So, yeah, DoorDash, they're pretty good.
Well, ho-ho, Jordan Peterson, what are you doing on here?
Well, that's simple, Adam. I heard you talking about DoorDash, and I immediately appeared. I mean, just think about it. You can order from anywhere. You could order from your car, and you could order from a parking lot. You can order from the comfort of your own living room. You can order while on the toilet in a Walmart bathroom, perhaps, where people have discarded battery packages because they stole the batteries out of them. I mean, just think of that, Adam.
DoorDash, we're the bomb, the bat bomb. Huh? Oh, no, just kidding. But we are pretty cool. DoorDash, we're fast. Batman fast.
That's all, folks. Man, I want some ice cream.